A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindi newspaper for 22nd September, Sunday. On the front page you have assembly polls in Maharashtra, Haryana to be held on October 21. So by-elections to 64 assembly seats and Samastipur's Lok Sabha seat are going to be held on the same day. And this is the schedule for the elections, you can see detailed out here. Then this is 60 foreign militants infiltrated into Jammu and Kashmir, says state police chief. So he says recruitment of locals though is at an all-time low. So this is regarding how foreign militant infiltrating Jammu and Kashmir. Then this is UP farmers end protests on Delhi border after assurance. So this is regarding the farmer protests. We had seen they had the list of demands and they reached, they were marching towards Delhi with their demands, but the march has been halted after center agreed to 5 of their demands. So you can see the details here, you can see. So we have been told that the farmers will have a greater say in deciding the crops minimum support price. Then also the government is going to, UP government is going to write to the central government to increase the daily payment for cow maintenance. Then another demand which has been accepted is also focusing on the resources of the Namami Gange program towards making Hindon and Kali rivers pollution free. Such demands have been accepted. So that is why now the protests by the farmers of UP has been halted. Then below you have Chandrayaan 2 is a huge success, ISRO chief Sivan. So this is what ISRO chairman K. Sivan has said at IIT Bhubaneswar convention. He says that scientists will get 7.5 times more data from Chandrayaan 2. Then this is Gully Boy's official entry for Oscars. So this is the Bollywood movie which will go as official entry to the 92nd Academy Awards in the Best International Feature Film Foreign Category with this is Zoya Akhtar's movie Gully Boy starring Ranveer Singh and Alia Bhatt. Then on page 5 you have Green Panel tells Central Pollution Control Board to regulate import of waste tires. So this is National Green Tribunal which has told the Central Pollution Control Board and has given directions to prevent dumping of waste tires in the country. On page 7 you have coastal cleanup drive draws volunteers in huge numbers. So people have vowed to protect beaches by adopting the dictum of reduce, reuse and recycle. So this was a huge cleanup drive at Puri beach in Odisha on the occasion of International Coastal Cleanup Day, which was held on which is observed on 21st September. On page 9 you have Vikram and Pragyan fade into lunar sunset, their battery is likely to die. So after Vikram unexpectedly crashed on the moon minutes before its descent, so the Vikram lander had Pragyan within it, the rover. So both are going to fade now, they had life of 15 days, so their batteries are likely to die and they will be faded. So actually expected to make a soft landing on the moon on September 7, but that did not take place. Then this is government sets early red line for Ganga hydro projects to ensure flow levels. So center has cut down by 2 years the grace period accorded to hydropower projects on upper stretches of the Ganga for complying with environment flow requirements. On page 11 you have India fundamental partner in climate action, UN chief. So United Nations Chief Secretary General Antonio Guterres has said that India is a very important actor and fundamental partner in international efforts on climate action and is making fantastic efforts to grow its renewable energy basket. He lauds the huge investment in solar power too. On international page you have Iran warns against aggression after US sends troops to Saudi. So USA has sent its troops to Saudi. We have seen Saudi oil bases were attacked, and for this, though Houthi rebels took responsibility, the Houthi rebels are supported by Iran, but USA directly pointed finger at Iran. So Iran, however, denied it, and now US is sending troops to Saudi Arabia. So Iran has warned against aggression. And below you have suspension of apps by Facebook reveals scale of data privacy issues. So Facebook said it has suspended 69,000 apps in connection with the investigation taking place on apps improperly sucking up users' personal information and other transgressions. So this is important. Then on business page you have norms revised to enable AIATSL sale. So buyer can retain Air India arms ground handling business across 76 airports for 7 years instead of 3 years now. So government has revised a contentious clause in the ground handling regulations to enable sale of Air India's subsidiary Air India Air Transport Services Limited. So attempt to privatize this, which is one of the few profitable entities of Air India, which was launched in February, but there were several delays. Interested bidders raised queries about tenure of assured business from Air India, grandfather rights, and the ground handling company, ground handling that the company had at 76 airports. So clarifications and revised norms are there to attract bidders now. Then below you have SEBI tightens norms for liquid funds. So these funds must hold 20% of net assets in liquid assets. So this is part of the attempts by SEBI to strengthen the risk management framework for liquid funds. And this is council refers GST on horse racing to group of ministers. So some states have opposed the taxing of prize money on horse racing, but this will be referred to a group of ministers. So due to paucity of time, only two ministers were able to speak on the issue at GST council meet. Then on Sundays, you have this FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions. So the first question is, are Saudi Arabia's oil supplies vulnerable? So the drone attacks in the West Asian region have made this region more tense. So why has that become more tense? And is it an all-out conflict? Is there an all-out conflict possible? And how will it impact global oil economy? So all these questions are answered in this detailed coverage, which is very important. And this is the end of smoke without fire. So this is regarding Indian government banning e-cigarettes. So why it has been banned and what do we know about it? What do we need to know about their use and their health concerns? So that is detailed out here. Then on Sundays, you also have science and technology coverage. So here the first news is genes implicated in bipolar disorder identified. So the team has studied a large family with many affected members and has identified the relevant gene variation linked to the disorder, bipolar disorder. And this is genetics reveals origin and evolution of black buck chinkara. So black buck ancestors came into India from Sahara Arabian region about 2 million years ago is what the researchers confirm and assert. So this is nano curcumin enhances BCG vaccine efficacy. So this is curcumin, which also helps in activation of innate immune cells known as macrophage and dendritic cells. It enhances BCG vaccine efficiency to BCG vaccine, which is given for TB, pulmonary TB. Then Sundays you also have dispatches coverage, which is on important international issues globally. So here you can see first one is from Brazil. It is safe on streets, unsafe inside the house. So it is said every hour 4 girls under the age of 13 are raped in Brazil. This is what the government data shows. And this is, as you can see, unsafe inside the house. It's a real cause of concern. And this is regarding Pakistan press freedom. So it says press freedom on the line as Imran moots media quotes. So the proposal has come in for criticism from opposition journalists and rights groups, because in Pakistan government under Prime Minister Imran Khan is considering setting up media courts. And then this is game for games with tempered buzz. So this is regarding 2020 Olympics, which will be held in Tokyo, Japan. So the emphasis is on cost cutting and sustainability. And lastly, this is trade war spurs India-China digital embrace. So technology leaders met in Shanghai to discuss ways to expand their footprint globally. So India and China have come together and they want to expand globally. And on the last page you have From the streets to the climate summit. So youth leaders mobilize at the UN to urge the world leaders to take action for sustainable future. So you can see these are youth leaders, Greta Thunberg and fellow climate activists with UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres at UN in as such. So they have reached United Nations with the concerns on climate change which they have been focusing and trying to gain attention on. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com. Thank you.